When it comes to game development, the most asked questions are always related to money. How much does making a game cost? How much money can you make with a game? Can you make a living as a game developer? Can I get rich with video games? Etc. In this video, I will focus on the topic of how much money do indie games make? Hi, my name is Auro. I'm a solo indie game developer and I'm the creator of a game called Mortal Glory. I also make weekly YouTube videos sharing my tips to help you on your own game dev journey. If this is something that interests you, I highly recommend subscribing to the channel. Now let's get into the topic. How much money do indie games make? There are obviously big differences depending on what game you are talking about. But to give some sort of an answer to the question, let's first take a look at some video game revenue data and see what interesting observations we can make from that. After that, I will show a few real-life examples of how much money specific indie games have made. So let's start off with the data. A site called Video Game Insights has collected data from Steam of 50,000 games and they have made some earnings estimates based on the price and the number of reviews each game has. Now, this data is not the exact truth as Steam sales data is not public, but estimates like these are usually pretty close and they give us the best insight based on what is publicly known. If we look at the data, we can see that the 50th percentile is around $4,000. What this means is that half of the games make less than $4,000 during their lifetime. If we look at other percentiles, we can see that 20% of all the games make less than $60 during their lifetime. Then, if we go to the other end, we can see that 20% of the top earning games make more than $60,000 during their lifetime. Let's also take a peek at where we all want to be at. The top 1% of games on Steam make more than $19 million each. So here's your life lesson. Be in the top 1% and everything will be groovy for you. Or if you are modest, maybe you can settle for the 98th percentile and a measly $6.6 million game. Now, this was all the games on Steam, meaning that it includes indie games, but also big games made by AAA studios. Luckily, we can filter the data so that we are only looking at self-published indie games. This will give us a somewhat more accurate look at what the numbers look like for the average indie developer. This is what we were afraid of. If we look at the 50th percentile now, it says that half of the indie games make less than $3,000 during their lifetime, instead of the $4,000 when we were looking at all games. This is not really a surprise though, since bigger games usually come with bigger marketing budgets and all that. The bottom 20% is not affected much. Also not a surprise, since a AAA game making less than 60 bucks would be quite a thing. The top 20% of self-published indie games makes more than 32,000. Ouch. Almost half of what it was for all games. But hey, this data includes free games also. Free games are quite bad at making money, so let's filter those out of the data also. Okay, looking a bit better. 50% of self-published indie games with a price tag make more than $5,000. The bottom 20% make less than $700 and the top 20% make more than $48,000. Let's add one more filter to the data. We only want to make good games, so let's only look at the games that have a rating score of 70 or more. Getting better. More than $8,000 earnings for half the games. And more than $100,000 for almost all games in the top 20%. So overall, if we expect we are quite average and in the middle of the line, our game would be making around $8,000 during its lifetime. That's quite nice if you are making games as a hobby, but if you want to be a professional indie game developer, you will need to make more per game so you can feed yourself. If these numbers didn't depress you enough, let me put the final nail in the coffin. These are the gross sales. If you want to find out what the developer gets, you have to deduct a lot of other costs like Steam's cut and so on. In a Gamma Sutra article by Danny Weinbaum, he came up with a multiplier of 0.38. This means that for every dollar sold, the developer gets 38 cents. Based on my game's data, my multiplier is a bit higher, but I assume it will also drop when I eventually put higher discounts on Mortal Glory. So I assume that 0.38 is a good estimate for the whole game market. If we take the median value of $8,000 we looked at earlier, this would mean that the developer gets around $3,000. And then the developer will need to pay income tax for that $3,000. With these numbers, it would be easy to come to the conclusion that you should not make indie games if you want to earn money. And that is a valid conclusion if you are just looking at the money aspect. On average, you are much better off working pretty much any other job. But I like to make a slightly different conclusion on the data. First of all, you should not get into making games if you don't like making games. Secondly, to me, this reinforces my belief that you should not approach game development with the mindset of making one game and hoping it takes off. Instead, you should approach game development with the intention of making many games. I think it's a fair assumption to make that by making games, you will get better at making games. And by publishing games, you will get better at publishing games. So your first game might be somewhere here, your second game here, your third game here, your fourth game over here, and so on. If you approach game development with this attitude, your expectations will be more in line with reality, and I think you will have a higher chance of becoming successful. Before we move on to some real-life examples, I just want to mention that the data we looked at is not really the full truth. It's fun to look at and gives some sort of a picture, but you have to note that it does not account for team sizes, marketing budgets, in-app purchases, platforms other than Steam, the age of the game, regional price differences, and so on. So take it all with a grain of salt. Alright, let's go through a few real-life examples I found and see how much money they have made. King Sim, a 8-bit kingdom simulator that was released May 2020 on Steam. The solo creator of the game recently made a YouTube video revealing that the game has sold $18,000 in 6 months. Neversong, a hand-drawn action-adventure that was released in May of 2020 on Steam. The creator revealed on a YouTube video that the game has made $90,000 in 6 months. The game is also available on other platforms, but that sum does not include the revenue from them. Starcom Nexus, an action RPG set in space that was released in December of 2019 on Steam. The solo creator of the game revealed in a Gamasutra article that the game has sold almost 30,000 copies in 6 months, bringing in a revenue of $460,000. Toast Time, an arcade game fueled with British humor. The game was originally released in 2012 on Android and later introduced to other platforms also. The creator recently made a Reddit post revealing that the game has made $44,000 over its lifetime. Curious Expedition, a roguelike expedition game originally released in 2014. One of the two creators made a blog post last summer revealing that the game had sold 173,000 copies between 2014 and 2019, bringing in a total revenue of around $1.6 million. This sum also does not include revenue they got from a Humble Bundle deal. Then there's this hidden indie gem I found called Minecraft, I believe. It was made by some guy called Notch. I couldn't find exact numbers, but I read that it has also sold a decent amount for an indie game. Good for you, Notch. With these real-life examples, you should also note that the sales numbers are just one part of the truth. They don't reveal how much time and money was spent on the game, or if they have publishing deals, or some other relevant factors. It is also more likely that you will hear about the successful games rather than the non-successful ones. These were just a few examples I found that had been out for at least half a year. If you are curious about a specific game, you can try estimating its revenue with the same formula that the Video Game Insight site uses, which is price in dollars times number of reviews times 60. It won't be fully accurate and doesn't account for discounts and all that, but it can give you some sort of an estimate that's probably closer than just throwing a dart into a wall. At this point, you might be wondering, how much has my game, Mortal Glory, sold so far? Well, the game has now been out for a full year, so I'm planning on revealing the numbers, but I want to make a separate video about it so I can dive a bit deeper into the details. That will be my next video, so look forward to that. But that's all I have for this video. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one.